Hello, welcome to the Sound of Science, the place where we deconstruct unscientific bogus and silly scams. Let's go get them. Hello, you wonderful critical thinkers. Today, I will show you how to destroy flat Earth with one simple question. It's really very simple. We don't need any observations, measurements, or other evidence. We don't even need to have a debate with these flat Earth fools. All we need to do is ask them one single question that makes their brains melt. I have tried it several times and it really works. So, imagine you run into a flat earther that could be online or in real life, it doesn't matter. And of course, it also doesn't matter what the topic of your conversation is, because within less than 1 minute, they will always start whining about their flat earth nonsense, just like any Christian apologist will mention their fantasy god in the first minute you meet them. Note that almost every flat earther in the Western world is a Christian. Anyway, once you have indeed established that they indeed believe that they live on a flat planet, then ask them this question. How do you know that we're not living on a cube? You might have to repeat that question for them because often they have trouble grasping three-dimensional concepts. So, how do you know that we're not living on a cube? Because how would you know the difference between living on a flat planet or living on a cube planet? Because you would experience the exact same thing. If you were living on a cube, the world would look like one huge flat surface. You wouldn't be able to see any curvature, and the other sides of the cube would be around the corner of the side that you are living on. They would be over the horizon, so to speak. So you wouldn't be able to see any of the other faces of that cube. All you would see is this one flat side of the cube that you are living on. So you would see exactly the same thing as you would see if you were living on an entirely flat planet. Now, for many flat earthers, this kind of three-dimensional thinking is absolutely one bridge too far. But they do know when they are defeated. So that part of flat earthers is then likely to walk away and start whining about being victim of scientific bigotry or something. But then there is this chance that you run into the kind of flat earther who thinks he's still in the game. They're mostly men, mostly Americans, mostly Christians. And I've had one of them saying, well, a cube is still not a ball, so gotcha. Those, of course, are the most hilarious idiots, because they still have no idea where this is going. So then your next question could be, how do you know that we're not living on a dodecahedron? You see, a cube is a three-dimensional shape consisting of six squared faces. A dodecahedron is kind of a cube, but then with 12 faces. And these faces aren't squares, but pentagons. So each face has five identical sides. It's a bit like a cube, but a little bit rounder. Yet, if you were living on one of those 12 faces, you wouldn't be able to see any of the other faces. They would be over the horizon, so to speak. And again, you would be living on a surface that was totally flat. So there is no way for you to distinguish this from living on a cube or living on a flat earth. Yes, this is another moment for a certain type of flat earthers to walk away, complaining about being victims of close-minded science believers or something. But this usually is the category who knows where this argument is going and that it is total defeat for them. But for those flat earthers who think they are still in the game, I usually do one final exotic shape like the truncated icosahedron. The icosahedron has 32 faces and it's basically the shape of a soccer ball. So how do you know that we don't live on a soccer ball consisting of 32 flat faces? Again, you wouldn't see the difference between living on a soccer ball or living on a cube or living on a flat earth. The thing you observe would be exactly the same, because you wouldn't be able to see any other face of the soccer ball, because these other faces would be over the horizon. By that time, about all flat earthers have run away. They are stupid. But there is one thing they usually do understand, and that is defeat. And their usual response, of course, is walking away, whining about scientific conspiracies that try to suppress the truth by mixing our atmosphere with chemtrails so that we don't notice the matrix and the fact that all royal families on Earth consist of reptiles who were pharaohs in their previous life or something like that. And all you can do at that point is establish that thinking we live on a flat planet is an exotically stupid idea that is only held by individuals who are either stupid or dishonest. Thanks for watching.